Volkswagen claims this is the sharpest handling version of a deceptively quick, tremendously practical car that's relatively affordable. It should therefore prove a desirable device. Indeed, what we have here is the MK 7.5 Golf R Estate, equipped with the performance package, an optional extra that costs £2,300 and is already available on the hatchback. Included are 19 in Spielberg alloy wheels that replace the 18 in Cadiz items of the standard car, and a new lighter R performance brake setup with silver calipers. More on which in a moment. Aesthetically, there are no other changes, and the R remains a car whose performance is smugly incongruous with its unimaginative design. In terms of hardware, it's also business as usual. VW's flexible EA888 2.0-litre turbo petrol engine driving all four wheels through a 7-speed dual-clutch automatic gearbox. There has never been a manual option for the Estate R, and a Haldex multi-plate clutch. Volkswagen's electronic differentials are nothing of the sort, and instead manage the transverse distribution of torque on each axle via the brakes, as with the GTI. Suspension is by McPherson struts at the front axle, and there's a multi-link setup at the rear. Our test car is fitted with £850 DCC adaptive dampers, which operate through four modes ranging from comfort to race, with an individual setting in which their firmness, along with parameters for the steering weight, engine response and so on, can be selected to taste soon to be sliver slower than before. Presumably one side effect of getting this engine to conform to new WLTP emissions regulations is a slight slump in power from 306 bhp down to an original pre-facelift 296 bhp. A more restrictive exhaust setup designed to reduce nitrogen oxide levels is to blame. Fair cop, those modified engines aren't quite here yet though, and even when they do arrive, we doubt the R will feel any less subliminally bewilderingly quick in the real world. It's the type of car in which overtaking requires little or no preparation, and then it stunned the official 0 to 62 miles per hour time is 4.8 seconds, but it's the engine's mid-range and gear tractability, not to mention 280 pounds-foot of torque between 2,000 and 5,400 revolutions per minute, that makes for such effortless flowing cross-country pace. And when it comes to speed performance, Packards have a further trick up their sleeve. Bring one out in 6th or 7th, and where the electronic limiter would normally bring proceedings to an abruptish halt at 155 miles per hour, the car will continue to pull onwards. Not that we put this to test out on the open road. Top speed has been increased to 168 miles per hour, 2 miles per hour more than the hatchback, which features a downforce inducing rear spoiler not fitted to the Estate. It makes this unassuming Estate the fastest Golf money can buy, but these all-weather hot Golfs have always been about more than straight line performance, and that's true of this particular variant. Grip and traction are little short of immense, although this being a Golf R on Continental Sport Contact 6 tires, that's akin to saying the sky is blue. It's in the details where most satisfaction is found. The steering is quick and feelsome, and due to the larger wheels, responses perhaps a fraction crisper during that incipient moment of turn in on exit. The R still adopts a conspicuous rear-driven stance where front-wheel drive rivals such as the seat Leon Cupra ST would begin to seep wide, and there's an overall agility that belies the bulky Estate bodywork. In the wet, it'll oversteer under power, and with a well-timed lift of the throttle, the additional weight over the rear axle can be used to help rotate the car on the way into bends. If that sounds gung-ho, it certainly doesn't seem that way from behind the wheel. The R remains one of the most intuitive cars of its type you can buy, and playing around at the limits of the chassis feels natural in no time at all. The special brakes save 2 kilos and use built-pin discs where an aluminium pot and the discs themselves are joined by cast pins. VW claims this helps the discs to expand radially when hot, providing better durability and pedal feel. We're unable to verify the former claim, but have no complaints concerning this car's ability to shed speed with predictable precision, barring a slight feeling of over-assistance. Indeed, complaints are thin on the ground there. driving position could be lower. You can't get the Agrapovic Sport exhaust that's available on the hatch, and the DSG box can be a bit shunty at low speeds. That's it. Fundamentally, the Golf R Estate remains an enviously good package. It's quick but refined and so enjoyable for a car with almost as much boot space as a Skoda Octavia. In short, it's a fabulous everyman style GT car, and elements such as 12.3 in display that now resides within the instrument binnacle keep it feeling contemporary. Nevertheless, while those who regularly find themselves on the remaining D-restricted stretches of German Autobahn will be tempted by what the performance pack offers, British drivers are best off leaving this particular option box unchecked. The improved brake setup is welcome, of course, but it's unnecessary for road driving. Meanwhile, the Spielberg alloys rob the R of some delicacy. Along rough or roads, a worthwhile sacrifice in the hatch perhaps, but a questionable trade-off in a broad battered estate, especially given the asking price, where Oxfordshire UK price £38,425 on sale now. Engine 4 sills 1984cc turbo petrol power 206 bhp at 5,500 to 6,500 revolutions per minute, torque £280 foot at 2,000 to 5,400 revolutions per minute, gearbox 7 SPD dual clutch automatic, curb weight 1,593 kilograms, top speed 168 miles per hour, 0 to 62 miles per hour, 4.8 seconds, fuel economy 39.2 miles per gallon, combined CO2 164 grams/km, rival seat Leon Cupra ST, Ford Focus RS.